This is Korey Rowe, producer of the franchise 9/11 Loose Change, the video series that claims that the government was somehow behind the attacks of 9/11. Listen to what he says about how he gives his video away for free.
I mean, you tell us that we're in this for the money. We're the only documentary that gives ours away for free.
Okay, what Corey is talking about here is giving away a video for free is they give away a previous version as a marketing tool. Yeah, they give away, when their second edition came out, they gave away their first edition for free. They made them cheaply by themselves at home, give them out as a marketing tool. And when they handed them out, they said, hey, we got a new edition coming out. So yes, he gives his videos away for free, but he's still making money off of them.
I mean, you tell us that we're in this for the money. We're the only documentary that gives ours away for free.
A long time ago, I found Loose Change's website where you could purchase these their items. And I went there now. The link was broken, so I had to find another way in. And there's no pictures, but as you can see in this picture, 9/11 Super Pack DVD collection. U.S. price is $44.56. Investigate 9/11 T-shirts, hoodie. $24.44.
I mean, you tell us that we're in this for the money. We're the only documentary that gives ours away for free.
The second screen cap I took shows you more items, which is Loose Change second edition DVD recut, $17.95. Loose Change final cut DVD, $19.97.
I mean, you tell us that we're in this for the money. We're the only documentary that gives ours away for free.
This third picture shows another page. I scanned down the page again. Loose Change Final Cut T-shirt, $16.95. Loose Change Trilogy 3 DVD set, $22.48.
I mean, you tell us that we're in this for the money. We're the only documentary that gives ours away for free.
I called into a radio show about 2 weeks ago, 2.5 weeks ago, and asked Corey, if he's not in it for the money, then why did they make a trilogy of the Loose Change? And my point is, I've watched Back to the Future a bunch of times. I've watched Part 2 a bunch of times, and I necessarily didn't like Part 3, but I bought the trilogy because it's a set. Corey and Dylan both know that trilogies sell more copies of individual DVDs. It's like the Empire Strikes Back Star Wars trilogy. They got two trilogies, so they know what's going on. Corey's claim was, well, the reason we updated from the first edition to the second edition to the final cut was more and more information came out. And I didn't ask him that night. I didn't have a chance. But if more information came out and you changed it to the second edition, why didn't you discontinue the first edition instead of having misinformation out there? And why didn't you discontinue the second edition because the final cut had different information out there? So by making a trilogy, you're proving that, yes, and at $22.48, Corey, you're selling DVDs. You're making money off of Loose Change. You're not just giving it away. And there's other avenues people could pay for it, too. So by having a trilogy out there, you got two DVD editions with misinformation, so you're selling misinformation. According to you, you updated your DVD Loose Change because there was new information that came out. So why haven't you discontinued the previous versions?
I mean, you tell us that we're in this for the money. We're the only documentary that gives ours away for free.
On Friday, March 14th, we agreed to have a debate on the Matt Haisley show. He's on the Armed Radio Network. You can find him at Facebook on Armed Radio 1. His producer, Mike Allen, who also has a radio show on that network, was also on, and they would talk before me and Corey came on the line. They were talking about it, and this is what they said.
And I had never even thought to look into this stuff until you had Corey and Dylan on, and then I started looking, and then, I did the research before KT came on, and it's interesting, to say the least.
Yeah, it makes you think, you know, a lot about it. You know, I mean, you and I are both ex-military. Both of them are ex-military. I mean, it just makes you, you go in the military and you feel, oh, okay, yeah, everything's, you know, up and up. And, you know, it was a compelling movie that made me want to do is get him on to at least talk about the, you know, the movie, why it was made. And while I did, KT contacted me, and you know, we became, you know, became one of those topics where, I mean, it was a lot involved. I mean, there's, you know, the more you look into it, I mean, there's so many different things. You really have to, you know, take your time and research it, because there's a lot of people out there that, you know, they're just making it, you know, videos and stuff, and, you know, I mean, they fake them and do everything with them, but
yeah, and you're right.
The 9/11 movie was one that I, you know, it's a long movie. I mean, it's not just a.
And that's the one,
you know,
on Netflix, right?
Video.
That's the one on Netflix.
Correct.
Loose Change, yeah.
Okay, so right there, Mike Allen just said that they were on Netflix. For anybody that don't know how Netflix works, you can't just gather a bunch of movies and play them at will. You have to sign contracts. The people have to give you written permission, and every time somebody clicks on a movie, that the copyright owner of that movie gets credit. So every time somebody clicks on the Loose Change video, Loose Change gets credit. And either it's every month or every quarter, every 3 months, they get a check. So they're making money off of Netflix as well.
I mean, you tell us that we're in this for the money. We're the only documentary that gives ours away for free.
All right, Corey, we heard you. You want people to think you're not making money off of Loose Change. What I'm going to do is I'm going to post two links in the description of this video. The first link is going to be to their Loose Change money-making store. This way you can go see for yourself that you could buy those items if you wanted. The second link is going to be to their Facebook page. If you want to find out if you're going to get blocked, which you probably will if you post this video, to copy the link to this video and post it to the Facebook page of Loose Change. You can write anything you want in the comment, in the post. Say, like, hey, I found this video on YouTube, and what do you have to say about it? Or you could just simply post it by itself and then go back and see if it's still there. I guarantee you that it's going to be gone, because they're covering up, and that will show you that they are covering up. There are two places on the Facebook page where you can post comments, and the first one is where it's a brand new comment. It goes on by itself. That has to be approved. So if you want to check this out, post it there. Take a screen cap of that and save it as a picture for whatever use you want to do with it. Now, the best bet is to post on an existing comment. It will get through right away. You can also take a screen save of that for whatever, as a picture. But when you go back in about, I don't know how often they monitor that page, but it's eventually going to be taken down, because I've been through this. They blocked me. And to nip this in the bud so you won't post again, they're more than likely going to block you right away. So if you want to build a case against them for hiding evidence and covering up the truth, if you're interested in that, or if you just want to see if they're going to block you for your personal knowledge, go ahead and post the link to this video on their Facebook page, which is in the description of this video. Hey, I appreciate everybody's time, and let's go ahead and shut these idiots down. Thanks.
I mean, you tell us that we're in this for the money. We're the only documentary that gives ours away for free.